श्रीमान् वेङ्कटनाथार्यः कवितार्किक केसरी वेदान्ताचार्यवर्यो मे सन्निधत्ताम् सदा हृदि स्वादयन्निह सर्वेषाम् त्रय्यन्तार्थम् सुदुर्ग्रहम् स्तोत्रयामास योगीन्द्रः तम् वन्दे यामुनाह्वयम् नमो नमो यामुनाय यामुनाय नमो नमः नमो नमो यामुनाय यामुनाय नमो नमः यत्पदाम्भोरुहध्यान विध्वस्ताशेषकल्मषः वस्तुतामुपयातोऽहम् यामुनेयम् नमामि तम्
श्रीमत्कृष्ण समात्वाय नमो यामुन सूनवे यत्कटाक्ष एकलक्ष्याणाम् सुलभः श्रीधरः सदा नमः यामुन पाद अब्ज रेणुभिः पावित आत्मने विदित अखिल वेद्याय गुरवे विदित आत्मने नमः अचिन्त्य अद्भुत अक्लिष्ट ज्ञान वैराग्य राशये नाथाय मुनये अगाध भगवत भक्ति सिंधवे।
स्फुरत्किरीटाङ्गदहार कण्ठिका मणीन्द्र काञ्ची गुण नूपुरादिभिः रथाङ्ग शङ्खासि गदा धनुर्वरैः लसत्तुलस्य वनमालयोज्ज्वलम्
नेक्स्ट् वर्ड् इस् तुलस्य 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 बै दि basil, by the basil leaves, todasya. And it's in what you call instrumental case, that means with the basil leaves. So it has been strung, all the basil leaves are strung into a garland. So mala is garland. Vana mala, generally todasi garland is called vana mala. So you can also, because todasya is the separately given here. Generally we say Tulasi Vanamala. The garland has been made from the garden of, we don't say, mean forest, we can also say forest. Because lot of Tulasi plants are there in the garden, we call it a forest. If you want to say garden, it is Upavanam. Vanam is forest. A small forest is called a garden. So Malaya, Vanamalaya, so generally as you know the Bhagavad Gita, Patram Pushpam Phalam Toyam, Yome Bhaktya Prayachati, Patram, any patram is enough, any leaf is sufficient to please the Lord, but only the devotion is very much necessary, and therefore especially Tulasi is meant for Lord Vishnu's worship. Bilbam is meant for, specially meant for worship of the goddess Mahalakshmi as well as Lord Shiva. Suppose we have an elder brother. So Vanamalaya Tulasya, the forest garland, the leaves of the forest garland made up of especially Tulasi, especially basil leaves. Then you have Ujjwala. So we are talking about the now full personality of the Lord, full figure of the Lord. We are referring to, not only we are referring to the top of the head, crown, the shoulders with the shoulder bangle, the neck with the pearl necklace, as well as other necklaces. Then you have Kaustubha gem on the chest, or rather any white gem on the chest, or blue gem on the chest, blue sapphire. Then the hip, so the Kanchi Gunam, the belt, the Nupura, the anklet in the leg. Then again come to Tulasya Vanamalaya. On the chest we have the Tulasi garden, basil leaf garden. Therefore, everywhere the beauty is there. Lord is handsome, very handsome. Actually, that who is handsome with a shining, as you said, diadem is a crown. Diadem is a crown. The royal crown is called the diadem. So you have bracelets. Bracelets is called the angara bracelet, rather shoulder bangles. So you have the chaplet of beautiful. The word beautiful is ujjalam or lasat. Yeah, lasat is beautiful. Fragrant. The word fragrant is not there. And the translator is also immersed in the beauty, and he is saying fragrant. We are generally talking about a fresh tulasi offered to the Lord. We don't generally, though tulasi can be offered because plucked 2 days back. For example, today is Friday, tomorrow is Amavasya day, new moon day. Day after tomorrow is Sankramana Dinam. Join in the first day of the month. And so 3 days we cannot pluck the basil leaves. So we must have planned to pluck the basil leaves yesterday, that is Thursday. And therefore, so whatever we got from the plants on Thursday should be kept up to Monday. So Monday only you can have a new fresh. But I don't know. But basil leaves will have a fragrance even after 3 days. And it will also be very effective in controlling the phlegm in the throat. And it will clear the throat and we will have no, what we call, cold. We will not catch cold. We will not have sore throat. These are all some medicinal properties of the tulasi. Here, so this is the beauty of the Lord, total beauty of the Lord from top to bottom, from head to foot. This is what we call Vishnu Keshadi Padanta Saundar. This is the beauty from top to bottom. So, leaves are acceptable by Mahalakshmi. And Tulasi is also called Devi, the goddess. The garland itself is called the Devi. And it is also called Vanamala in feminine gender, Vaijayanti Mala in feminine gender. Generally, Mala itself means feminine gender. So you have the other Tamil meanings are there. 36, number 36. So Padavarai. Word meaning, Purate, Kirita, Angada, Hara, then Mani, Indra, Kanchi, Guna, Nupura, Adi. In Tamil, it has been separated in the Sanskrit words. Then you have the Prakashikira Kirita, shining diadem. That's what we had it as. Initially we said the Spurat. Initially Spurat. Then we have the term in last quarter. There are two words, the Lasat and Ujjala. That is how it is. Prakashikira Kiritam. Tholvalaihal. I told you shoulder bangles. Haram, the pearl necklace. Then Thirukkazhuthu Ani. The necklace. Necklace, Thirukkazhuthani, that means whatever jewel one can adorn with. Then Si Kaustubam. Manindra is called Indra, meaning leader. Leader meaning best. Manindra is best gem. The best gem is supposed to be Kaustubam. Because Kaustubam came from the Milky Ocean. therefore it's called best vidya. Taru arai non. So kanchi guna. Arai, in Tamil, arai meaning hip. The bosom. So non meaning guna, namely thread. So even for the bow string, we say non, means string. The string of the belt string is called non. So kanchi guna is taru arai non. Thiru is not generally beautiful. So Thiru Chilambu. Chilambu is the name for male anklet. It is also called in Tamil Thandai. Thandai is a male anklet. Nupuram, what you call Kolusu. The jingling anklet called Kolusu. It is what it is meant for women. The girls also. Girls wear what you call Kolusu. And men wear what we call silam. So, mudaliye thiruvabharanangalalum. Whenever we say the jewels, the ornament, we also say auspicious ornament. Thiruvaram, thiruvabharanangalalum. Then you have rathanga, shankha, asi, gada, dhanuhu, varaihi. So, it is mentioned, I don't know why. The commentary does not say, because both are popular. Chakram is popular. Everybody knows Sudarshanam. And Shankham, everybody knows Panchajanyam. So they are not mentioned here in the commentary. So Nandakam Ennum Vaal. This is mostly unfamiliar. The sword is called Nandakam. The word Nandakam itself, you may know that it makes the Lord happy. Nandam karoti iti nandakam. Nandam is anandam. And it creates bliss in the Lord. So how can a weapon create bliss in the Lord? Because it protects the devotee. And it annihilates the enemies of the devotee. Then you have Kaumodaki. Kaumodaki yendum gadai. Kaumodaki, the maize is soft like a flower. What flower? Lily. Lily is called Kumudam, as all of you may know. Kumudam is lily. So the lily flower, it is made up of lily flower. In the sense, the maize is soft. How can the maize be soft? It should be heavy, it should be hard, it should be rough. It should kill the enemies. Only when the devotee is this soft. Therefore, Kaumodaki. Kaumodaki. Then Sargam. Sargam is the name of the bow. And Lord is called Sargapani. And then in Kumbakonam, the holy place is called, he has also another temple called Chakrapani. Pani hand, which possesses both the conch and the disc. So, vill ennum, shangam ennum, vill ennum, ayudangalalum. The word in commentary is not available in Yamanacharya Stotaratana. Because he doesn't want to say, call them weapons. Weapons means something dangerous. Weapons means harmful. Weapons means to kill someone, to destroy someone, it is not mentioned there. Dhanur Varehi, they are also the best ornament. Lasati Tulasya, it's a what you call printing mistake. It is not Vasati Tulasya, it is Lasati Tulasya. So Prakashikum, Tirthurai Ode. Even the basil garland is very bright. Rasat Tulasya. Now you know by the contrast, the black body, we saw that. We saw the black body. We saw Lord Krishna black in figure. We saw that he is also black like a cloud. Water-bearing cloud. And because of the contrast, the green color of the basil leaf is bright. Prakashikam Thirutvayavade. Commentary says, Unsetyal, because the Tulasi garland is attached to you, because the garland of basil leaves is won by you, because of your association, because of your contact, it is shining. Then Manamalaya. Manamala, the garland made up of leaves from the forest, include Tulasi. Thirukkurai Udaya Manamalaya. Maybe the whole garland is only made up of only Tulasi, or it may contain so many other leaves, so many other flowers, and Tulasi. Ujjalam Prakashipavanaho. The Avatarika in single line, Purathu Iti. Purathu, etc. Abanana, Ayudha, Adhikarudaya, Shethi Alaki Anbarukkara. This is what I already told you once. Samudaya Shobha. Samudaya Shobha. Collective beauty. So he is enjoying, Lord, Yamunacharya is enjoying the collective beauty of the Lord. So he adds the jewels and also the weapons. Abharana Ayudham. Ayudham Abharanam. Abharanam Ayudham. The ornament can become weapon, the weapon can become ornament. So that is the beauty here. Now, how do we understand this richness of jewels? Why so many jewels? Why so many ornaments? Meaning, Lord is the master of two worlds. Number one, Vaikuntham, namely, or otherwise called Nitya Vibhuti. And the other one, namely Leela Vibhuti, the creation of all the creations which are meant for his game, his sport, his Leela. And because he is the Lord of both the worlds, Ubhaya Vibhuti Natha, Ubhaya 2, TWO, Vibhuti Prosperity, that means property. A property of prosperity. He is the leader. He is the master. He holds sway over these two worlds in order to show that he holds the power over these two worlds. There are two aspects, namely number one, jewels, number two, weapons. Now you have separately each jewel is significant. This is what it is being said here. Aishwaryathukku anurupamai. So I was telling you this earlier also. The word Aishwaryam means leadership, and richness. Grandeur of everything plus the leadership. The leadership is more important than the grandeur. So Aishwaryam meaning wealth. Aishwaryam, which normally we understand as wealth, the richness, the prosperity, and Anurupamai, in tune with the richness. திருமுடியிலே விளங்கா நிற்கிற திரு அபிஷேகம். How do we understand the Lord? Obviously, he is the master of the two worlds, because you find his head with a crown, a crowned head. His head is all, head wears the crown always. A crown will be adorning a head if he is the head. He is the head of the entire creation. because he is a king. Ranga Raja is in Tamil. Ranga Raja, Govinda Raja. So we got so many words. Then Raja Rama. So that way everybody is a king. King Krishna, Raja also, Krishna is also Raja. Krishna Raja, we have names of people of it, Krishna Raja. He was the king of Yadus, Yadavas, the cowherd of it. Thirumudi lay over the head. It doesn't mean over the mudi, meaning the hand, lots of hair. Here the Thirumudi meaning the, over the head. The Vilanga Nitra Thiru Abhishek. So whenever a young prince is anointed to become the king, we have what we call Abhishekam. Abhishekam is otherwise, in Vaishnavite terms, it's called Thirumanjan. That is the holy water purified by incantations of the scriptures will be poured on the head of the king, and that is called Abhishek. That is meaning anointment. Anointment is done by, after anointment, we add the crown to the head. Now, how is the crown? The Tamil Divya Prabandham says, Kadirayiram iravi kalandu erittal otta neen mudiyile. The head is very large, the head is majestic, the head is big, so neen mudi. So how is the neen mudi? What is the brightness of the head? How is the brightness of the head? Kadirayiram iravi. Iravi meaning sun, ravi. Ravi in Sanskrit becomes iravi. Sometimes it is misunderstood as iravu is night. The iravi, generally, the Tamil grammar rule says you cannot start with these two letters, a word in Tamil. La and ra. L and R. We cannot have the beginning letter of a word. Then how do you use the word? How do you use the word with the la and ra? So we say ila, and then we can say ara or ira. There are two types of beginning word. Iravi, or if you take a snake, the aravu. We say arangam. Srirangam is called arangam. Tamil, arangam. Lalgudi in Sanskrit meaning Lalgudi in Tamil becomes Ilalgudi. This is the grammar, Tamil grammar. So Iravi meaning Surya, the sun. Ayiram Iravi, thousands of suns. Kadar ray. The sun is blazing, each sun is blazing, thousands of suns are blazing. Kalandu erittarpo. They have come together. All the thousands of suns have come together. Kalandu erittarpo. They are blazing. They are burning. It's not a question of here the heat of the crown, but it means the brightness of the crown. The flame is very bright, effulgent, highly, highly bright. Kadirayiram iravi kalandu erittal otta neen mudiyile. Lord's crown looks like thousand suns. S-U-N. Then Angada. Sarva Ashrayamana Thiruttol Valai Patri Vilanga Nindrulla Thiruttol Valai. The shoulder bangles are called Angadam. What is the purpose of the shoulders of the Lord? All the people, meaning devotees, they come and take, rather embrace the Lord. They closely come to the shoulders and then recline on the shoulders. So in order to give what we call peace of mind to the disturbed soul, the individual soul, like a human being, will have what we call the shoulders as their resort. எம்பெருமானுடைய பெருமானுடைய தோள்கள் தான் நமக்கு ஆசிரியம். தட் மீன்ஸ் தே ஆர் தி ஷெல்டர் ஃபார் அஸ். த ஷோல்டர்ஸ் ஆர் த ஷெல்டர் ஃபார் அஸ், நாட் ஓன்லி ஃபார் அஸ் சர்வாசிரியம், ஃபார் எவ்ரி ஒன் த ஷோல்டர் இஸ் தி ஷெல்டர் ரெஃப்யூஜ். ஸோ இட் கிவ்ஸ் ப்ரொடெக்ஷன், மீனிங் த பவர் ஆஃப் த லார்ட். த பவர் ஆஃப் த லார்ட், வென் யூ சே யூ ஹேவ் காட் அ பிக் ஷோல்டர், so the shoulder meaning the strength of the hand is known by the size and the grand, the beauty of the shoulder. The hand is very strong, and therefore with the hand he uses the weapons and kills the enemies of the devotees, and therefore the shoulders are called the resort to, right resort to all sarvashrayamana. திருத்தோள்களை பற்றி விளங்கால் என்றுள்ள திருத்தோள் வரை ஹார. தி ஷோல்டர் பேங்கிள் அரவுண்ட் தி ஷோல்டர், தி ஷோல்டர்ஸ் ஆர் தி ரெஃப்யூஜ் ஃபார் ஆல் தி டிவோட்டீஸ். ஜென்ரலி வி சே லார்ட் டிவைன் ஃபீட் ஆர் தி ரெஃப்யூஜ், அண்ட் ஆல்சோ வி ஹேட் டு சே that the Lord's assuring words are the refuge. Maa suchaha sarva bhutebhyo abhayam dadami. These are all words by words, oral words, and they assure us protection, and therefore they are called refuges, the resorts. So they are the final destination. The hand shows you fall at your feet. The hand shows like that. Fall at your feet. Fall at my feet. Don't worry. Maa suchaha. Maa mekam charanam vraja. Fall at my feet and be free without worry. Be free from worries. Now hara, the pearl necklace, is otherwise described by Alvar, ponnin ma maniyara maniyaga tilangumal. Mal, mal is Thirumal, Lord Vishnu is shining, ilangum, ilangu meaning, there are three words in Sanskrit here, lasat, ujjalam and purat. First word is purat. In the last quarter, you find two words, lasat and ujjal. So how is he bright? How is he shining? Ponnin maamaniyara maniyara. So gems are inlaid in the gold. The gold is shining as well as the gems in the gold. Embedded. So gems embedded gold ornament. So ponnin மாமணியாற மணியா. How much what is the size of the gem? As much as possible. You can have big gem, biggest gem, and then the gem is inlaid in the gold. The gold and the gem shine, make the lot. The all the wealth make him shine. Endrum, you see, periya varai marbil pair aura. His chest is very big. His therefore periya varai marbil. The chest is like a mountain, as big as a mountain. Varai, varai means mountain. Periya varai meaning big mountain. The chest is like a big mountain, and in order that to make the chest beautiful, you must have big necklace, pair haram. The word haram is given as aram here. So pair aram. So it's a very big necklace because the chest is also big, the neck is also big. So we are talking of the Virat Swarupam or Vishwarupam, or you find in many temples, including Tirupati Srinivasa Perumal, we have got a very big figure. According to the chest of the Lord, size of the chest of the Lord, the necklace is also big. The pair aram, big necklace. என்றும் சொல்லுகிறபடியே விளங்கான் என்ற திருவார். தி நெக்லஸ் இஸ் ஆல்சோ ஷைனிங் அண்ட் கண்டிகா திருக்கழுத்திலே விளங்கான் என்ற முத்து. முத்து கட்டுவடம், முத்து கட்டுவடம். Can you show me the full paragraph in page 93, just on. So starting with the 36, last line 36, after 36, I think we go to the next page or? No, padavare, okay, 37. So we will go up to 36 end. So we find that muttu kattu vadam. Muttu kattu vadam. Vadam means gunam, Sanskrit gunam, meaning thread, meaning rope. Especially when you see a chariot of the festival in a temple, you will find a vadam. Vadam is a very big rope in order to pull the chariot. So vadam here, according to the size of the big size of the chest, we have muttu kattu vadam, pearl necklace around the neck. The neck is also big, the chest is also big, and therefore muttu kattu vadam. The pearl necklace is also big. We have a pair aram and muttu kattu vadam. This necklace is very close to the neck. The neck is very big, and therefore the necklace is also very big. So we have a diamond necklace and pearl necklace. So we got two necklaces, diamond necklace and pearl necklace. How do you understand? We can have to imagine, we have to add. So Manindra, Avantanakum Sadar Pradhaniyamana Kaustubha, Avantanakum. So our bhakti, our devotion is to offer ornaments to the Lord and become happy. We feel happy on adorning the Lord. We feel happy that we offer an ornament to the Lord. And when not only that, he likes it. He likes the particular ornament. What is that ornament? That ornament that came from the Milky Way, Kaustubha. How does he like it? He likes it always. He likes it forever. Why did he like it, or why does he like it? Because the Kaustubha gem came from the Milky Ocean, the very source of his wife Mahalakshmi. Because Kaustubha was born along with Mahalakshmi, he likes it more. So Kaustubha, the white gem, has a great fascination for the Lord. So Avantanakum, even he likes the ornament, Sada, forever, all the time. Prukhaniyaman, his ambition is to wear the Kaustubha gem on the chest, the white gem. அவந்தனக்கும் சதா ஸ்புஷணீயமான ஸ்ரீ கௌஸ்துபம் மணீந்திர. மணீந்திர, we are referring to the best white gem. காஞ்சி குண திருவரையில் விளங்கான் என்ற அரைநூல் பட்டிகை. When you say பட்டிகை, it's a broad size of a thread. Broad size of a thread. இட்ஸ் லைக் வாட் யூ கால் பெல்ட். திருவரையில், திருவரையில இந்தி ஹிப், இந்தி ஹிப், இந்தி ஆஸ்பிஷியஸ் ஹிப் விளங்கான் என்ற பியூட்டிஃபுல்லி ஷோயிங் அரை நூல் பட்டி, அரை இகெயின் ஹிப், நூல் குண த்ரெட் ரோப் பெல்ட் பட்டிகை இது கால் காஞ்சி கூட. த வேர்டு காஞ்சி ரெஃபர்ஸ் டு பிரைட்னஸ், பிரைட்னஸ் காஞ்சனம் கோல் காஞ்சி. காஞ்சி ஹஸ் நாட் லாட் ஆஃப் மீனிங் பட் ஹியர் மீனிங் பிரைட். த பெல்ட் இஸ் பிரைட். நூபுர திருவடிகளை பற்றி விளங்கான் என்றுள்ள திருச்சிலம் நூபுர இந்தி மேல் ஆர்னமெண்ட் நேம்லி இந்த மேல் ஆங்க்லெட் அதரை கால் தண்டை அது தமிழ் அனதர் நேம் ஆல்சோ இட்ஸ் மென்ட் ஃபார் மேல் மெம்பர் இட்ஸ் அ பிக் ஒன் விச் ஹேர் காட் ஜெம்ஸ் இன்சைட். So there are gems like pearl or the red gem, manikyam. You have got manikyam inside the thandai, inside the what we call the circular shaped hollow ornament made up of silver. So adi shabdathale palabalave avarana. Ye, ye is palabalave avarana. God said, I mean, Alvar said, there are many names to the Lord. So, Namam Palabalave. And also, Abaranam Palabalave. Ornaments are also many. His names are many. Everything connected with the Lord is only many. In legion. Unlimited number of everything connected with the Lord. His pity also, sympathy is also unlimited. So 258. Aparimita Divya Bhushana Endrum Salivarabadiye Asankhyatam Yenne. So just now we saw that Bhushanam ornament, Divya Bhushanam divine ornament, Aparimita Divya Bhushanam unlimited divine ornament, unlimited number of divine ornament. And therefore, they are not countable. Asankhyatam. They are not countable. Now, we go to the next set of ornaments, namely Rathanga, the weapons. Rathanga. Inda Aabaranangalodu Vikalpikkalambadi Shobhavahamana Divya Ayudhangalin Chethiyai Anubhavikkirar. There is no difference between the ornaments and the weapons. But generally, one can differentiate, but there is no differentiation according to the quality of the weapon, nature of the weapon, namely, decoration of the Lord is the main purpose of the weapon. They are not meant for always killing the enemies of the devotee. Violence is not their forte, is not their speciality. The weapons remain very calm. They remain as only inert beauty objects in Lord Shiva, divine. So, Rathanga, so they are shining. They are shining. They are divine. All the weapons are divine. And Yamanacharya wants to enjoy what we call the collective beauty of the weapons of the Lasat Tulasya Vanamalaya Ujjvalam. Now, his wearing the basil leaf garland included in the garland of flowers from the forest. He is shining. Because it indicates a fresh as the translation says, a fresh, fragrant Tulasi garland, basil leaf garland, indicates that he has got all leadership qualities. For everything, he is a master. And it also means he is all rich. He is all rich. Nobody is richer than him. Sarva Aisharya Suchakamaya. The Tulasi garland shows that he is very rich. Then Thiruvadigal Alavum Thaandu. Now this is the beauty here. So starting from the neck, the Tulasi Mala, the basil leaf garland, is so big that they touch the divine feet of the Lord. Tamil Nadu, Nilai Malai, Nilai Malai. The garland covers from the neck to the foot. That is that's a very big garland. Very big garland. According to the size of the figure of the Lord in a temple, you have got a full garland. Garland from the neck to the feet. Then Abarana Ayudadigal Thannai Patri Vilangugirayum Avattale Thaan Vilangugiraymaga Chellugirathu. Parivartan Pillai's commentary is impartial. He says, the jewels adorned beautify him, he beautifies the ornament. The weapons beautify him, he makes them beautiful. He makes the weapons also beautiful. So that means, commentary of Parivartan Pillai gives value to the devotees also. The weapons of his devotees, they also must be appreciated. The jewels also serve the Lord. As servants, the servants must be given some appreciation. And therefore, the ornaments beautify the Lord. The Lord in turn beautifies them. This is the quotation for 259. Srak Vastra Abharanaihi Yuktam Sva Anurupaihi Anupamaihi Chinmayaihi Sva Prakashaihi Cha Anyonya Ruchi Ranjakai. We must find out the source where from it has been used. Is there any footnote? I don't know. I am not familiar with this quotation, but the words are obvious, the meaning is obvious. Lord wears garlands. The first word is garland, shrug. Lord wears a lot of garlands. Vanamala is there, that is namely Tulasi Mala is there. Then you have the weapons as ornament. Then necklace, pearl necklace. Then you have another necklace close to the neck. Then you have Kaustubha gem adorning the chest. And even the head has got garland. Even the crown is being adorned with a lot of garland. The garlands are everywhere. Then vastra, the dress. Especially we saw Ujjala Pita Vasatam, the yellow silk dhoti, that is veshti, is the vastra, is the dress. Vastra. Then Abharanehi, lot of gels, Abharanehi, with a lot of gels, Yuktam associated. Then Sva Anurupaihi Abharanehi. So all this garland, dresses, ornaments, are in tune with his form. They are not incongruent. They are not dissimilar. All of them fit in. All of them rightly fit in his figure. there are people who wear jewels, many jewels. Then we may not have a liking to see them. The ornament and the beauty of the human personality sometimes may not go close to each other. And therefore, now what is speciality? There are no parallels to the jewels and the weapons which beautify the Lord. So anupamaihi, upama simili, anupama no comparison, so no parallel. The Lord is wearing garlands, dresses, ornaments similar to his form, similar to his natural beauty of the body, of the what we call divine body, and they are also unparalleled. They have no comparison also. Now you find that, starting with a sample example of chakram, the wheel, the discus, sudarshanam, on the right hand, we call them all of them as knowledgeable. All the weapons and all the ornaments are knowledgeable. They are wise. Chinmayi. They have good thinking. They have good thoughts. They have wisdom. Another meaning will be ornament, which fit in according to the limbs. According to the limbs, the belt must be in the hip, the necklace must be on the neck, the anklet must be on the leg, the garland must be on the shoulder, and gems will be studded everywhere, but especially in the crown also. Gems will be studded in the crown. So we have Navaratna crown, 9 gems crown, and so on. So we have diamond as a small necklace, because diamond is very costly. Diamond necklace is smaller compared to other garland, but according to the size of the chest, the diamond necklace is also very big. Then all of the ornaments and all of the weapons are self-effulgent, svaprakashaihi. All of them are themselves self-effulgent, self-bright. They don't get light from anywhere else. But only one thing is, because they are associated with the Lord, they are self-bright, svaprakashaihi. So they have no external agency to give them shining, give them the shine, but they are self-effulgent, they are self-luminous. Then anyonya ruchi ranjakaihi, so each of them does not fight with each other. In fact, they love each other. They show or extend the beauty to each other. They don't fight with each other. They don't become opposite to each other. So here, anyonya, mutually, ruchi. Ruchi here doesn't mean taste, it means brightness. Ruchi generally means a taste, as all of us know. There are 6 tastes in our food item. So ruchira meaning beauty. Here we are talking about ruchi only, not ruchira. Ruchira meaning beautiful, attractive is called ruchiram. But here ruchi, then ranjakaihi, the ornaments there, then and there, that is in their own respective places, add beauty to the ornament, the weapons. add beauty to the ornament. The ornaments add beauty to the weapon. They are mutually complementary to each other, and therefore anyone ruchi ranjakam. So each of the weapon and each of the ornament supports the other ornaments and weapons. Meaning, they don't mar the beauty of the Lord. In fact, they add to the beauty of the Lord. So the chakram and the shankam, the wheel and the conch, the mace, gada, the bow, sharangam, and the sword, nandakam. All these add to the beauty of the Lord instead of showing some, what you call, indifference towards the other order. So they are, one does not feel proud that I am the best ornament and you are the worst ornament and so on. They don't fight with each other. Everyone is fond of the other. Namely, the jewels within themselves, the weapons within themselves, then the jewels and the weapons within them. They are cooperative to each. So in order to make the Lord highly beautiful, most beautiful on earth, and on Nitya Vibhuti, namely Vaikuntham. So these jewels and ornaments, jewels and weapons, try very hard to please the Lord by being mutually cooperative. So with this, we can go to the footnote on both pages, namely 92 and 93. So we have Periyar Thirumazhi 411, yes, and Periya Thirumazhi and Moonram Thiruvandar. The first one. கதிராயிரம் இரவி கலந்து எரித்தால் ஒத்த நீள்முடியன் எதிர் பெருமை எதிர் இயல் பெருமை ராமனை இருக்கும் இடம் நாடுதிரே அதிரும் கழற் பொருதோல் இரணியனாகம் பிளந்து அறியாய் உதிரம் அடைந்த கையோடு இருந்தானே உள்ளவா கண்டார் As Madam Shanta Varadarajan told us yesterday, the divine experience of Alvar is unparalleled. So here the Periyalvar talks about Lord Rama by that right, incarnation. Yedir il perme. He has got so much greatness that he has no enemy, no opponent, there is no opposition. And Avisi is head, the head, the crowned head looks like the brightness of the thousands of suns, thousands of SPNs, thousands of blazing suryas. How can you have a look at thousand suns at a time? And so what should he do? So we must approach Rama. Irukkum idam naadugirel. If at all we approach Rama, who has no opposition and whose head has been adorned by thousands of suns in brightness, and Adhiram Kadar Poru told. Now we are now talking about Narasimha. Lord Rama is also Narasimha, the best man. Whereas Narasimha is the combination of the lion and the man. Simha, the word means lion, it also means best. Rama was the Raghava Simha. He is called the lion among the Raghu kings, Raghu race kings. He's called Raghava Simha. And he is Narasimha. What did he do? Iraniyan Aham Pilandu Ariyay. He tore open the demon Hiranyakashipu. And therefore, his shoulders were very big, large, perutol. Kalar perutol. What is that kalar? Kalal is the name for the shoulder bangle in Tamil. Kalal. And we call it Veerakalal also. Whenever a king goes to a war and wins over the war, when he returns, people, the subjects of the country will offer an ornament called Kalal. And you can even count the other, what you call the male anklet in the leg by the number of the bracelet on the leg, which shows that he got victory over so many wars. So Kalal is the honor given to the king at the foot. So Adhiram Kalal Purudol. By the greatest personality of the Lord, even the male anklet makes a lot of what we call thundering noise. When Hiranyakashipu was torn to pieces by the lion. So what did he do after tearing the demon into pieces? Udiram alainda kaiyodu irundhaan. The condition of the boon that Hiranyakashipu got from Lord Creator was, my blood should not fall on earth. My blood should not fall on earth. Therefore, what was he doing? What was Narasimha doing? Udiram alainda kaiyodu irundhaan. His hands were fully drenched by the blood, and he was trying to find out how not to drop the blood on the earth. Therefore, he drank the blood. Urinji purinjivar. So udiram alainda kaiyodu irundhaan. Who has seen both this Rama and Narasimha? Ullava kandar ullar. This is the Mahavishwasa of Priyalvar, Vishnu Chitra, that the great faith that he assured us that there are people who have witnessed both Narasimha and Rama. Don't say God is absent, there is no God. Don't become an astika, don't become an atheist to say that there was no Rama, there was no Narasimha, there was no Krishna. There are people even today who have seen the gods, namely Narasimha and Rama. Ullava kandarula. As it is described here by me, the gods appeared so to in person to some people. So this is the meaning of the first quotation. Periyarvatarumi 411. The third quarter in Tamil is the important quotation here. So, Tunduma Manimudi Mel Thura Yalangal Tondumal in Gindanar, Minuma Mani Makara Kundalangal Vil Vishum in Gindanar, Ponin Ma Maniara Maniara Tilangumal in Gindanar. கன்னிமா மதில் புடைத்து கணபுரத்தம்மானை கண்டோல் கண்டார். What is the proof that this lady has seen the Lord? A special Divya Kshetra is mentioned here. It is near Tanjavur and it's called Thirukkannapuram. So, Thirukkannapurathamman, Kannapurathammani, Kandal Kollur. you ask a lady who will describe how the Lord looks in Tirukkannapuram. Then if you know her description, if you hear her description, it means that she has gone there, had a darshan seva of the Lord. So what are the statements to be given by the girl in order to prove that she visited the temple? So Thunduma Mani Mudi male, beautiful gemmed head, a crown made up of gems is on the head. Tulai Alangal, so you have basil leaf garland. Tulai Alangal, Thondrumal Enginnaan. If she says that she has seen the garland, Tulasi garland, the basil leaf garland on the head of, on the crown of the Lord, then we can understand and she has gone there and she had the seva. We can believe her. What is the second sentence? What did she say? Minnuma mani makara kundalangal vil vishum enginrala. If she said that the ear studs of the Lord kundalangal vil vishum, the ear studs of the Lord, if they are attractive, if they are sending arrows to us, will be shown. You can also say, instead of sending the arrow, it throws the bow. Minnuma mani makara kundalanga. Ava the ear stud, makara kundalanga. It is, they are in the form of fish. And they are the best fish. And they are bright gems, made up of bright gems. So if a lady says that the ear studs made up of fish symbol with the gems in line, then we can understand the lady has visited the temple called Tirukkannapuram. So, Pondin Mamani Yar Maniyahar Kilangumar Enginrala. So, when the lady, or girl or woman describes the Lord Vishnu, that the gold and the gem inlaid ornament, Ponnin Mamaniyaram Aniyahasthikal, then we can understand that he had a seva in the temple called Tirukkannapuram, the Kshetra called Tirukkannapuram. And the three proofs are there, PROOFS, proofs are there, that we can easily identify that the girl has gone and worshipped in a particular Kshetram called over his fall gem crown.
It's actually tall gem. It's a mistake. Tall gem.
Fall gem, meaning?
Tall. T, ta, ta, ta. Tall. Tall gem.
Oh, tall gem, okay. Tall gem, okay. Nedumudiya, that is the exact Tamil word. Nedumudiya. So, tall gem crown. This is G-E-R-M, no? G-E-R. So, tall gem crown, he wears a wreath of fresh tulasi. If she says that, his makara fish earring, gold set with gems, flash like lightning, if she says, his gold and gem necklace sways on the Jal Mighty broadcast, she says, strong mighty walls rise in Kannapuram. Has she then seen him? Strong mighty walls rise in Kannapuram. மூன்றாம் திருவந்தாதி, மூன்றாம் திருவந்தாதி. பெரிய வரை மார்பில் பேராரம் பூண்டு கரிய முகிலிடை மின்போர் தெரியுங்கால் வானொடுங்க வண்டரையும் பங்கயமே மற்றவன் தீ நெடுங்கண் காட்டும் திறன். So I was, we were seeing the description of Yamanacharya's Sotaratnam with regard to the commentary of Priyatam Periyavatam, right? That we saw earlier that his chest is as large as a mountain. Periyavarai marvil. In the chest of the Lord, which looks like a big mountain. Peraram pundu. He is now wearing a big garment. Big necklace, big pearl. Kariyamugalidai min pola. Avirdi, avirdi. He is like a black cloud. He is like a water-bearing black cloud. The necklace is like the lightning in the black cloud. Kariyamugal is black cloud, namely Lord. Black cloud like Lord. Then Idai Minpola in the middle of the Lord, you find that the necklace, the chest necklace. The necklace is shining like a lightning. So Pola Periyendal, if you can identify, we all identify that Lord is like a black cloud, and the necklace, the big necklace, looks like the lightning. Then, Paan Udunga Vandarayam Pangayame. So, he looks like a lotus Pangayame. That is called Pankajame. Paan Udunga Vandarayam. The beetles come to the flower to drink honey, and then Matravandan Neer Nedungan Kaattum Neeram. Sorry, Matravandan, okay. Neer Nedungan Kaattum Neeram. His eyes are like fire. His eyes are big as well as fiery in nature. F-I-E-R-Y, fiery in nature. And that is the beauty of the Lord. And, you know, please go to the blue meaning of the third quarter. Okay. Still down. பாட்டென்று பெயர் பெற்றவை எல்லாம் ஒடுங்கும் படியாக அதிமதுரமாக வண்டுகள் இருந்து பாடப்பெற்ற தாமரை பூவை காட்டிட்டது. The bees which come to the lotus flower sing beautifully. They excel everyone who is adept in music, and so the last one, last line, well, this is, I think, last line. Okay, Nilnadingan Niram, the color of the hue, H-U-E, the hue of the Lord shows that the beauty, the here we are talking about the goddess here. The goddess here. The goddess of fortune is indicated by the Lord's colorful figure. And that the lotus is on the chest. Namely, the lotus is Mahalakshmi. And here we are talking about Alvar's singing in praise of both the couple. The divine cup. I think Pratyavati Bhayangar Vandangaratya will have. Okay, we are talking about the beauty of his eyes. The beauty of the eyes is like the beauty of the lotus. On his strong mountain-like chest, he wears long, beautiful necklaces and gems, revealing his dark frame like a rain cloud lit by a lightning. So his long red eyes are the hue of a bee hummingbird. His eyes look like bees on the lotus. The total figure of the eye is lotus. So in the eye, you have pupil. The pupil is black and they look like a bee. So this is a beauty. So we come to the close of the 36th verse.
Swami, there are two more.
Palapalave aabaranam perum palapalave. Palapalave shodhi vadivu panbennil. Palapala kandundu ketutru moondinbam. Palapalave jnanamum paambanai melarthidu. Where is the Lord? Lord Shiman Narayana is reclining on the serpent bed. Paambanai melarthidu. He is over the snake couch. He is over the snake couch. Paambanai melarthidu. What is the speciality of this Lord? His ornaments are many. Palapalame abharana. They are uncountable in number. They are numerous in number. They are numberless. The ornaments are numberless. Perum palapalame. Bhishma said to Yudhishthira and all other Pandavas in Mahabharata, the thousand names of the Lord. They are not thousand names. There are thousands of names. Unlimited number of names. Perum palapalame. Mahabharata gives us the text of Vishnu Sahasrama, where Bhishma advises Yudhishthira to chant Vishnu Sahasrama in the presence of, in the very presence of Lord Krishna, who is the target of the Vishnu Sahasrama, who is the essence of the Vishnu Sahasrama. So Perum palapalame. Palapalame shodhi vadivu panbenni. If you start counting, there are so many bright figures, starting from the fish incarnation. Even Narasimha was very much shining with fire-like anger. Palapalave shodhi vadivu, shodhi vadivu. You can also enjoy a temple figure. When a camphor light is shown towards the deity, that means umpteen number of figures of the Lord are shine. They look like light. Light is God. Then palapala kandundu. So what are we expected to do? We go to the temple, we see the Lord. Kandu, so we see him. Undu, we swallow him. We eat him. We take his beauty as our food. Undu. So Kate, we can hear the greatness of the Lord through the mouth of devotees from Divya Prabandham, the scripture, and so on. Kate. Then Uttu Mondu Inbam. So we can have a close embrace and imagine that we kiss the top head portion of the Lord. Uttu Mondu Inbam. Delve deep into the ocean of the beauty. Get yourself immersed in the beauty of the, in the ocean of beauty. Then you try to find out whether you can take some beauty home and explain to others who are at home how you enjoyed in the temple. So, inbam, then palapalave jnanamu. We were seeing a particular verse in the commentary called Chinmayehi Saprakashehi. The ornaments and the weapons have got wisdom, knowledge, they are wise. And therefore, while we approach the Lord, the Lord is so omniscient, he is very knowledgeable, that our knowledge also increases to manifold. Palabalave jnanamu. He is highly efficient. He is omniscient, all-knowing. And another meaning is the ornaments and the weapons are also having wisdom. They are not inert, lifeless material. So they also have. So that is why we have the word chinmayaihi. Because they have knowledge, they emit light also. Swaprakashin. They are self-effulgent, self-luminous. They don't entertain any, they don't receive any light from any external source. They themselves are bright. The ornaments and the weapons. So anything connected with the Lord is myriad. Plurality. Plural. Everywhere he is plural. So that is the greatness of the Lord. My Lord reclines on a serpent, let me count his ways. His ornaments are many, his names are many, his lustrous forms are many, their sensations too are many. Through sensations, that would be the palapalave jnanamu. Each ornament, each weapon, each form, everything is knowledgeable. Are many those through seeing, eating, touching, hearing, and smelling. He gives me pleasure. So when we see the God, when we follow the beauty of the God by our imagination, when we go and touch the Lord, when we hear the greatness of the Lord, when we smell, especially the tulasi, basil leaves in the feet of the Lord, he gives me happiness. So, illai nunukkanganai idanil piridannum mannam tollai tannulil sonna urvum arvum niye allithuyai alangalani marba en achudane வல்லதோர் வண்ணம் சொன்னாலது அதுவே உனக்காம் மன்னர். There are so many nuances, there are so many inner meaning in the personality of the Lord. There are books which tell us about the different forms of the Lord, incarnations of the Lord. Many books, good books are there, like the scriptures, the Divya Prabandha of Alvar, the Sotras written by great Acharyas. All of them have got so many nuances, inner meaning. And in whatever form we like him to appear before us. So, uruvum aruvum niye. He has got a shape, he has no shape. So, he is nirguna brahma and saguna brahma. He has got qualities associated with him. And another is, he is formless. So all these are meant in the scriptures, given in the scriptures. Nannuli is a good book. She is also in the good books of scriptures. The scriptures are good books. They explain him as a god of auspicious qualities in end of number. And at the same time, also they also give the interpretation Nirguna Brahma. Aruvangi. They have no shape also. Pama. Allitura Yalangani Mada. Alangalani Mada. He is addressing, God is being addressed by the Arvar. So, Allitura Yalangalani Mada. You can have two meanings also. In the chest, in his chest, already the basil leaf garden is there, and it decorates the chest, plus flowers, and also we are talking about the goddess of fortune decorating the chest of the Lord. Achyutane, yan achyutane, because you won't leave us in lurch, you are called Achyutane. I am addressing you, N. Achyutane. Valladhor Vannam Sannal Adhuve Onakkam Anna. Mention any color. Mention any best color. He is the Lord. Valladhor Vannam Sannal. Valladhor Vannam Sannal. Meaning, if you mention a favorite color of your own, Adhuve Unakkam Annan. You can see him in the same color, the Lord. So, according to the tuning of your mind, according to the tuning of the devotee's mind, Lord appears as imagined. So, you are the form and the formless spoken of in the Veda. The subtle inseparable from the grass, the end. Because we call him Antaryami, he is in everyone. He is inseparable. And he is subtle because as Antaryami, he is not visible to all. He is not visible to all. So inseparable, subtle and inseparable from the grass reality. The whole world of creation cannot be without him. Oh my Achyuta, with a Tulasi garland over your chest, whatever one attributes you, that you are indeed. So we are saying that in Tamil, color. Whatever color you want to attribute, he is that color. Sense, it means that the attitude, the emotion, the swabhava, the nature, all according to our imagination. He is all according to our imagination.
So Swami, I wanted to thank you very much for this class. I also wanted to expand upon what I said yesterday, that in yesterday's verse, in 35, it was talking about Lord Krishna, and you were saying that the Vedas are the breath of the Lord, and his breath has got the tinge of the smell of ghee and yogurt and everything. Yeah. And also we know that not only the Vedas, but Lord Krishna also gave us the milk of the Bhagavad Gita, Sarva Upanishado Gavo Dogda Gopala Nandanaha, that he is the milker of the Vedas. And he has brought the milk of the Vedas to us in the form of the Gita. And so now
Dugdham Gita Amritam Mahat. Dugdham Gita Amritam Mahat.
Yes. So I wanted to expand on that, because also in this verse we understand that the Lord is giving us the Gita and the Bhagavad Gita and the Vedas, like that. And then the Lord's ornaments and weapons, they are the alwars. They are giving us the Nalayer Divya Prabandha, which are explaining, giving the glories of the Lord. So the devotees here are the Nitya Suris, the alwars, and the alwars are giving us, the Lord is giving us the Nigama, the Gita, the Gita and the Vedas, and the alwars are giving us the Nalayer Divya Prabandha. And then further, we have the bees, we have the bumblebees. The bumblebees are taking the nectar from the eyes of the Lord, which is like a lotus. and from the tulsi garland and from the flower garland of the Lord, even from his head and everything. They're like the acharyas who are taking the fragrance and they are creating even more shastras for us to read, like Yamunacharya is creating this stotra. And it is like the honey which is made from the bees. And the bees are the also devotees of the Lord in Sri Vaikuntham, like that. So we have those three levels of shastra. We have the Vedas from the Lord himself. We have the Nalaya Divya Prabandham from the Lord's gems and weapons, the alwars. And we have from the alwars. And then from the acharyas, we have other shastras, like Yamunacharya's works and like the works of Vedanta Deshika and others. They are like the honey which comes from the bees who have drunk the beauty of the Lord.
A good analogy and comparison, a parallel. And as you said, one sample is Kaustubha is the gem which incarnated as Kulasekhar Alva. Of course, the Garuda is the incarnating as Brahma, is a very hard one. The Garuda and so on. I see that you also go deeper and see the gems and ornaments rather than ornaments, and the weapons also becoming the Alva.
Mudal alwars are the conch and the sword and the,
yeah,
right, mudal alwars,
right, the mudat alwar, pay alwar and puri alwar, and they also come from the lotus. They are born in the lotus.
Ionages.
And you find after Lord created the world, he wanted to redeem the world, he wanted to help the people who were drowned in misery. So that he incarnated many times, but still he was unsuccessful. So he sent the paraphernalia like the gems, the ornament and the weapon as acharyas, as alvas and acharyas. Then he was dissatisfied. In the Krishna avatara, he himself became a teacher. Then he saw that he was a failure, we say, just for joke. He was a failure because Arjuna was a bad student. And then after all, now we have a lot of preceptors, acharyas. So we explain the shastra. Right. You have divided it into three levels. Vedas are the breath of the God, breath of the Lord, and alvars and acharyas. And now today's recent acharyas. Has given a lot of material to chew, to think.
And also, I liked that verse that talked about Narasimha as being the best of the men. And you were saying that Rama is also Simha. And I was thinking that in Tirupavai, Krishna is also called a baby Simha. He's also called a baby. So all of the incarnations of the Lord are all Simha.
Chiriya Shingam, Yashode Ilam Shingam, first Patram of Tirupavai, Yashode Ilam Shingam is the young cub of Yashoda, young lion cub of Yashoda. Then you have the Mariam, Marimalai Murinjil, Mannik Kudandarukum, Chiriya Shingam Arivutra Tivri. Their Lord is woken up as a lion. And we also say Kausalya Suprajarama, Purva Sandhya Pravartate, Uttishtha Nara Shardula, tiger. Nara Shardula, tiger meaning best. The best, Nara Shardula.
And Kavitakika Simhaya.
Yeah.
Vedanta Deshika is also called he's also a Simha. And also all the Acharyas of Ahobala Mata are also Simhas. So the Lord is a Simha and everybody else is also a Simha.
Right.
Everybody is a lion. All the Acharyas.
Rukmini writes a love letter to Lord Krishna and he calls him Narasimha. In the 7 verses, Kale Narasimha. He wants to have Narasimha to be punctual. Since Prahlada and Karinakashipu vied with each other to show the Lord was ready in the pillar to come out, and therefore the beyond the nails, the hand did not become a lion's hand. Beyond the face, below the neck, it was human being. He was in a hurry to appear. Therefore, of course, Narasimha is called in Vishnu Sahasrama as the beautiful hands of God. Narasimha Vapu Sriman. Narasimha Vapu Sriman. The word beauty is associated with Narasimha. Because it is a rare beauty also. Such an incarnation never occurred earlier or after.
And also, I wanted to say one other thing. I was thinking that the Narasimha killing Hiranya, you were saying about how the Lord gets all the blood on his claws, on his hands, like that. So we understand from this, we understand that one has to die. One has to have no blood in his body. One has to actually die to go to moksha. The Lord is giving moksha only videha mukti. There's no jivan mukti, there's only videha mukti. The Lord is killing Hiranya, and after killing him, he goes to moksha. And it's the same thing with Bhishma when he speaks Vishnu Sahasranama. He's on the bed of arrows, but only he gets moksha after all the blood is drained from his body. So this is a proof of that videha mukti is only the moksha, and jivan mukti is wrong.
And it is said that, I think we discussed earlier, Bhishma had no power to fix the date of death, we say. Because he waited till Uttarayana, Thai month, January, after January 14th, in order that, the blood in his body, all the drops of blood in his body are drained because the blood was developed by eating the food of Duryodhana. But till the last drop of blood came out, he waited for it. And Arjuna prepared the arrow bend.
Right, because he had been living in the Kauravas' house and taking right. their food, and so we also we should not take the food of people who are bad people.
Right.
Yeah, and we should fast. We should fast after doing that.
Right. And it also said. We should not go to a person, a sinner's home. And Duryodhana is asking, why did you go to Vidura's house and insulted me without coming to my house? And he said, Dvishadannam na bhojayet. Dvishadannam. Dvishantam na bhojayet. Dvishadannam na bunjiya. You should not feed an enemy. You should not take food from an enemy.
So also in the Baranyasam, the Acharya is asking us not to go to other people's houses and take the food. So like Bhishma, we have to give up that food and that has to drain from our bodies and then only we can get the moksha.
So after digestion and what we call excretion.
No, we have to do the prayaschitta prapatti. We have to do fasting.
Swadayanniha sarvesham trayantartham sudurgraham stotrayamasa yogindraha tam vande yamunahvayam namo namo yamunaya yamunaya namo namaha namo namo yamunaya yamunaya namo namaha yatpadam bhoruhadhyana vidhvastasheshakalmashah vastutam upayatoham yamuneyam namamitam
Srimat Krishna Samatvaya Namo Yamuna Sunave Yat Kataksha Eka Lakshyanam Sulabhaha Sridharaha Sada Namaha Yamuna Pada Abja Venubhihi Pavita Atmane Vidita Akshila Vedyaya Gurave Vidita Atmane
Kavitarkika Simhaya कल्याण गुणशालिने श्रीमते वेंकटेशाय वेदांत गुरवे नमः।